Welcome back to the Night of the Rabbits. I've got a hint to figure out what I need to do. Okay? I wait till the day. I was on the right track with the water nut here, but I was using it in the wrong place. I didn't realize, but over here on the left, just right to the right of the boot, is a flooded path, which I forgot was specifically there. See, flooded path. So I need to use the water nut there. Not flooded area, just flooded path.
Let's see how much this fancy water nut can really hold. The nut took root, but it didn't really suck up a lot of water. I bet that a fully grown water nut tree can suck a whole pond dry, but I can't wait here for years watching the tree grow.
Well, I've got a solution for that.
Maybe we can provide some help for the little water nut tree.
Nice.
Wow!
That's the right attitude! Dear listeners, Burrower has dug himself out once again in one piece and dry as a bone. We will now continue with our program. Swamp Radio 103.6, 5. Mole in the morning, mole at noon, and mole in the evening. As always, we'll start off with my favorite music.
Okay. Finally, a new area. It feels like it's been forever since I saw something new. What's this? Is that a drop? I guess so.
Another one of those stickers.
Oh, it's a sticker. Great. I don't care about stickers. I want drops. Ah, like this one.
And another.
That should leave me about 13 left, I believe.
A blue root.
I got that beautiful dwarf root from the dwarves as thanks for promoting their blue juice on my show. But the listeners at home already knew that, of course.
What, are we talking live?
That's Buzzy, the dewfly. I call him that because he creates a bigger buzz than even I do. Actually, he belongs to the post office, but I've grown really fond of him. But, shh.
Hmm. I wonder if I can get him to come to me with,
I'd better be careful with the syrup.
Oh, never mind. Well, maybe if I have Buzzy with me, or... maybe I can... What was his name?
That's Buzzy.
Okay, it was Buzzy.
I caught him up, actually, but...
Maybe I'll be able to get myself into the special wing area because I've got it with me, maybe?
Looks pretty comfy to me.
I guess so. So what's this with this fox now?
Set up in honor of the foxes, or to honor the chickens.
Maybe I can talk to it. Let's try. Okay. Apparently it skipped a line. Let's try that again. Aha! Now maybe I can get that one fox to let me through. Awesome. Oh, I see. These crystal statues are indicating where the... they're just indicating where the portal trees are. Okay.
Statue. There's a little stone face in the crystal. And some kind of amber thing. Very fine sound. Very, very softly. Like someone flicked the glass.
I don't. Not that time.
Looks like a very large corkscrew.
It does.
Plato's mailbox. I wonder what's in there. I have a choice. Wet feet or ignorance. I'd rather stay dry and not know.
I wouldn't. I'd rather get my feet wet and find out.
Stylish. Judging from the mailbox, Plato lives here.
Well, Plato hasn't been able to get back to his house in all this time. Okay. Okay, what else is clickable? It's gotta be more. Pretty flower. Where?
What an awesome flower. I shouldn't pick it, but I just want to touch it anyway. This isn't a museum, after all.
Okay. Pointless.
And here next to me is Jerry Hazelnut. We all wish the young tree walker lots of luck. But now, on with the program.
Ha! I was on the radio.
We all wish the young tree walker lots of luck. But now, on with the program.
Why are you on repeat there, buddy? This is kind of a little bizarre, because some of the things, like... I don't know, I got the impression when I was in Jerry's world, like at the beginning of the game, I got the impression it was like in the 30s or something. He doesn't seem like a modern kid. Or even like 70s or 80s. He seems like he was from the 30s or something like that. So that's the impression I got. And yet this looks a bit anachronistic. I mean, this is a different world. So maybe this is like further in the future than Jerry's world. But I mean, like, this is clearly an earbud, which only came around the iPod time, right? So what's the deal with that? And also, that one guy mentioned video games before. Just seems like, to me, Jerry lives in a time before video games. That's just my impression, though. How do I get the Dewfly to come over to me? I want it. I want it. Give me it.
That's Fuzzy, the Dewfly. I call him that because he creates a bigger buzz than even I do. Actually, he belongs to the post office, but I've grown really fond of him. But, shh.
Maybe I need to go talk to Plato and rat him out. Where's Plato right now? I only know where he is in the night. Hmm. Okay. Well, I guess that was something. Maybe I could talk to the fox now. Hey, fox. Maybe?
You're funny, little bit.
Nope. Still nothing. Hey there.
They stationed me here as a Crow Scout and all that.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, I totally helped you out.
I must have collected enough berries.
Well, I'm all out of berries, so... not that I really expected to use them again. I was just trying it for the sake of trying it. Well, not sure where exactly to go then, or what to do. What have we gotten here? Any new hints? Okay, so I get the sense we need Buzzy with us. Either that or that butterfly thing. I don't know where we get the butterfly. I'm not sure how we get Buzzy. The only thing I could think of was to tell Plato about it, and because he said, shh, you know, like, why mention that he belongs to the post office and say shh unless that's a hint of what we're supposed to do?
And another.
Awesome. Okay, so, oh wait, I see another one.
Another.
Whoop. Sorry, didn't mean to do that. Not just yet, anyway. Oh, wait, I'll drop.
Another one.
Were those there the whole time I just never noticed them, or do they sometimes come and go? I don't know. It'd be weird if they came and went, so they must be there all the time, and I guess I'm just not very good at spotting them. Oh, well. Anyway. Sit down and have a read. So I'm pretty sure Plato is, around here somewhere. In the evening. Oh, wait, he is right in front of the fields, isn't he? Yeah. That's where. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, because he says the light is spooky. There we go.
There are some very strange, are they, Will and Owl?
Oh, that's it? Can't say anything about the damn fly? Frick.
That won't work.
Ah, nuts. Well, let's go up here again and try. You don't really expect anything different. Oh, wait. Why is this question mark? Something's different here. Aha!
That's Buzzy, the Dewfly. I call him that because he creates a bigger buzz than even I do. Actually, he belongs to the po-
He's over here now, so maybe it makes some difference. Well, I didn't mean to do that. Go back there, Jerry. Okay.
Play to the Frog. There's a message.
Nothing else. I thought you'd avoid night.
Young tree walker, lots of luck. But now, on with the program.
I thought he was. He said he didn't do this at night.
A blue root.
I got that beautiful dwarf root, but the listeners at home already knew.
Okay, maybe I can give him something for it.
No, I'll keep.
How about this?
No, I'll keep.
No, okay. Maybe I can catch the Dewfly.
No.
Aw, damn it.
I'd better be careful.
Try to get him to follow me by offering some
I'd
syrup.
I'd better be careful with...
Nope. Okay. I don't know.
That doesn't need it.
Nope. How about the rose hips?
Rose hips are cool.
Nope. I don't know what the hell I have the rose hips for. It kind of pisses me off that I got them so early. They've been bothering me the whole fucking game. Sorry, swear.
No, I'd better be-
What the hell do I do now? God damn it. I'll be back. Probably just gonna have to look this up again. God damn it, I'm looking things up way too much lately. And it bugs me. It really bugs me. But what do I do?
I bet you night owls out there are wishing the two of them luck.
I really don't see anything.
No, I'll keep.
Alright. See, one of my big problems I find is that when I discover new areas, I get kind of hung up on them. Like there, I was thinking like, oh, the Dewfly, what can I do with the Dewfly? What can I do with the Dewfly? How is the Dewfly going to let me get to into the moth area? And I don't know if that's relevant or not, but I've already got what I need to do something here, at least based on the quick hint I looked up. I forgot, he mentioned this is dry, it needs water. Alrighty.
It looked like you conjured the rain yourself.
Yeah, well, I...
There weren't even any clouds in the sky.
What is it, Jerry?
Oh. Awesome.
A fox!
I like it.
Who are you, Jerry? Be careful! Don't... Wow. Oh, my little froggy heart is still racing like crazy. Fortunately, the fox wasn't hungry for either of us.
That was no ordinary fox. Did you see how many tails it had?
I wasn't paying any attention to that, but what a scare. Oh, holy dragonfly.
Shut up, Plato.
The fox jumped towards the swamp. I have to go after it.
Oh, of course. I wouldn't be too afraid of that, though. Come on, it's Plato himself is bigger than that thing.
There it is again.
I'm betting it's going to take me, Yep.
It jumped further into the swamp. It almost looked like it was waiting for me. I'm going after it.
Awesome. Finally some progress here. Sorry, folks. I had to look, had a peek there. Ugh. Ah.
Huh? Where did the fox go?
Gee, I wonder. Other fox statue.
You caught me! Alas, now I have to go home.
The fox jumped into a portal. I can't let it get away again.
Let's do this.
Folks, you won't believe what I just saw.
I need to lay off the booze.
So, you finally returned to us, Kitsune. I hope you'll stay a little longer with us this time.
Oh, the fox skipped off. Again. So, its name is Kitsune. But who just talked to the fox?
This was amazing. Love it.
So where am I now? It is very quiet here, as if there are no people anywhere near. Only more of these fox statues. But I can hear a very soft ringing, or chiming.
Next time on the Night of the Rabbit, we investigate this strange new oriental world and chase the multi-tailed fox. See you next time.